autism is an issue that's of increasing interest in the United States and around the world. People with autism often report sensory difficulties, and we got interested in the idea that these sensitivities can be used to diagnose the risk of autism, even in situations where people might not have easy access to healthcare. My name is Sam Wong, and I'm a professor of neuroscience at Princeton University. It turns out a big thing that the cerebellum does is control eye movements. Studying those eye movements gives us a window into what the cerebellum is doing. Normally, when a sound and light go together, we might blink when we hear the sound. If we don't, it means our brain is doing something unusual, and that is a window into a risk factor for autism. The testing that we do in the laboratory is often done with equipment that weighs hundreds of pounds. Our innovation is to take this capability and use smartphones to make it miniature and available to anyone.
So this smartphone app is delivering stimuli that evoke certain responses. The stimulations that we are using are, for instance, a tone, or a light flash, or a vibration. And we are presenting those stimuli in certain patterns. By measuring, for instance, the blink reflex, we can predict what's going on in the brain. So we've been doing those testing for 2-3 years now at the Princeton Baby Lab. And we thought that when the pandemic hit, that might be bad for science. But at some point I started to realize that all the equipment that we need is basically in the smartphone.
I would love to see smartphone-based testing really reflect the full range of what's been discovered in basic and clinical neuroscience. The idea is that these technologies that are in everyone's hands can be harnessed to serve public health and to make people's lives a little bit better anywhere they are.